Volko is old world Atlantis. Yeah. What does that entail?
Well, he was advisor to Aquaman's grandfather. So he's basically a statesman. He's a political figure. He survived the destruction of the civilization because it's really a civilization that grew and then self-destructed and fragmented. And fragmented into these different kingdoms. So when we start the story, there's seven different kingdoms, and they aren't all together. And that's what makes him old world.
Talk about what Volko does for the young Arthur.
Volko is a teacher. He wants to give him the knowledge and the culture of Atlantis, because young Arthur is not living in the Atlantean world. He's a surface guy. And Volko, as promised to Arthur's mother, the queen, played by Nicole Kidman, I'm teaching him the culture. I'm teaching him how to fight. I'm teaching him how to swim. I'm teaching him how to use his special powers, being half Atlantean and half surface.
You've worked with a lot of great directors over your career. How does James Wan stand out? What was it like working with him?
He's great. I mean, you know, the scale of this kind of movie, James is great because the scale of this kind of movie, he's able to do that thing that you need, and that is have the overview and be able to manage the logistics without delegating too much, still keeping a personal vision of it, still having, controlling it, not delegating too much away that he loses what the movie is, but at the same time, able to do that, but also deal with the actors and find, you know, the way that they can personalize and touch down with it. Because these movies are very difficult logistically, because you have to anticipate things that are going to be done in post. They're very big, the technology is very complicated, they aren't normal, easy things to shoot. The pace can be very slow as well because of the difficulty. And that can wear people down and make them a little flat.
Yeah.
He's very energetic, he's very engaged, he's got a great film culture, and he knows how to work on the big picture and the little picture at the same time. And that's a gift. I've seen it before. Sam Raimi had that. I've also seen it sometimes when people don't have that capability. So it is a talent.
You know, I love that Volko is sort of this double agent. He's kind of playing both sides. Talk about that aspect of his character.
Volko is kind of Shakespearean in the respect that, his public face is not his private. It doesn't reveal his private motives. He's King Orm's advisor, closest advisor. But at the same time, he's plotting to depose him, basically. But it's not just a pure power play. He is trying to, at the same time, he's not sure immediately whether Arthur is up to it, but with time, he's convinced that Arthur is really the one to lead the people to coexist peacefully with the surface world, where Orm, he doesn't quite trust, because Orm, he sees, is really driven by, is kind of bent on war. And Volko's been around long enough that he's seen the cycle of things, and he thinks that's not going to be good for either the surface or Atlantis.
I think this is a DC movie that has the most fun. Was this a fun experience?
Yeah, it was fun. It was fun to do. I mean, I love doing the technical work that has concrete physical challenges, and to try to make something like the swimming. It's not a long sequence, but it's an essential sequence. When I'm teaching the young Arthur how to swim, you shoot a lot of footage, and you got to train for that. And that's great fun, because sometimes you're jumping from, 60 feet up and going down, diving, and skimming the floor and then doing barrel rolls. That's fantastic to do. That's fun. It's a concrete thing that you're doing that's like a skill. And then with that, when you marry it to the story, it can really put your imagination in a place that you can be the story.